If you guys want to get some awesome teams and guaranteed class players, make sure you go and check out footcoinking.com. Their link is down below. And if you use discount code B87, you get an extra 6% off your total order. Hi guys, and welcome to the Road to Glory Wager Showdowns, the last episode of 2014. So make sure you go ham on that like button, subscribe if you're not subscribed already, and if you do want an EMSP PSN codes ready for the all the packs tomorrow, make sure you do check out g2a.com. Their link is down below. So with the team itself, guys, we have been struggling in parts, and it's annoyed the shit out of me. It's a formation I am not used to, but hopefully we can get some decent wagers done today and some decent upgrades as well. If you do want to partake in any of the wager matches, make sure you do check out Gamer Saloon. Their link is down below also, and you guys can be in with a chance to play me if you are interested. Now obviously with the PlayStation 4 side of things, I have realized that things are very, very expensive, and it wouldn't be really worth my while to go on there, load up with coins and get wagers done. Even though I know I'm not playing the amount of subs that I do want. But hopefully in a few months, it all settles down and we can actually finish with one series on the PlayStation. But until then, we are on Xbox. We are going to be aiming to smash people, get their coins and upgrade the players to the probably the best possible Bundesliga team. And that does mean with Team of the Year around the corner, that we're probably going to be seeing a few Team of the Year players in that team. So the first wager match, we win 2-0 for today. The minimum wage is 8,000 coins, so you are going to see that figure a lot, and we do manage to get an upgrade. The aim today actually is to get everyone locked into a rare silver, and then hopefully the first episode of 2015 we will be going for the Inform special, which is three games where we go for Informs only in silvers. Now there is quite a few as well. There is the likes of Inform Han, Inform Bernat. A lot of people are very interested in Inform Bernat. I've not seen anyone do any player reviews on him. I've not seen anyone play with him even in squads. It's a bit of a weird one. But if you guys have, let me know in the comment section below what you did think of him. So the next wager, we are going for Brooks, the centre-back, the fast American centre-back. And we come up against this team, a very nice looking. Well, you think it's a very nice looking. It is actually very nice looking, but it's very underrated. There's a lot of players under 70 and a few dangerous ones at that as well. Now, this guy was very good at skills. He was annoying me for the first half, and thankfully we did manage to take the lead through Cadillac doing some nice individual skills and a first time shot by one. I don't even know how to say that guy's name, and I don't want to offend anyone, so apologies for that one. And we do make it 1-0, but just before half time he does get an instant reply, and it's Gale running on through. Now Gale's a very, very dangerous player. Never played against him before, and that was a brilliant goal by my opponent to make it 1-1. So with that, nothing else really happened. We do end up going into the extra time stage, and it was a very difficult game. It went on for a while as well. Usually when we go into extra time, guys, I do aim to get the game finished pretty early on. It took us until the 27th minute when Cadillac gets on the end of a high through ball and does tap it into the back of the net, making it 2-1 and walking away winners. So that does see us get Brooks into the team now, who is a very nice centre-back. You've not used him before. I don't mind Rudiger, though. Rudiger's a very tidy centre-back. 74 rated, very, very fast. But now we have Brooks in there to hopefully take us forward with this team. Now, this formation's in here now. I don't think I'm going to be staying with this formation. The reason I'm saying that, guys, is because I'm not enjoying this formation. It doesn't feel that good going forward. It doesn't feel that good very defensively, because then three centre midfielders, you do need to pick them correctly. Otherwise, you're going to end up with six attacking players, which is exactly what we do have now. So a rematch against the same opponent. Gale up front again, a very dangerous player. We just played against him, and thankfully this was the third game against my opponent. He did repeatedly accept the challenge to play me, and now I knew how he played. 1-0 off a corner, and just before half time, nice break with Baster, who is back in the team. Who we did get one of the early upgrades, does manage to chip it through to Eswine, who pumps it into the back of the net. Nice 2-0 lead. And it gets even better, because I've learnt not that this team does not have any free kick takers in it, and the only way to score goals is by actually passing it to someone, confusing my opponent, because not a lot of people do expect you to pass from a direct free kick, and we do manage to make it 3-0 with Malanda getting on the score sheet. He's then messed around a little bit in defence. We saw the over-the-top through ball to Cadillac, and he chips the keeper. Even though if the keeper did turn round, he probably would have caught it in two hands, but he never, he failed, and a nice 4-0 lead. And it doesn't finish there. In the 79th minute, we break on through with Leitner again, who is very nice at passing. He reminds me a lot how Alonso is. Doesn't really have the pace, doesn't really have the physicality, but he does have a nice passing ability to the other players. And I'm not liking taking him forward as well. We do manage to finish off the game and make it 6-0 with a nice ball to Chandler. Chandler then does link up with one, I think it was, and then obviously you've got an empty net for Cadleck to get on the back on and make it 6-0. This takes it to 3 upgrades out of 3 in this episode, and it does see Dick Meyer come into the team, and that is the rare silver stage of this team complete. Now, that isn't the last time you're probably going to see a rare silver in the team, because there's a high possibility we may lose a wager, guys, and have to downgrade, but fingers crossed that doesn't happen for a while. So, the next episode is going to be Inform Special. Make sure you smash the like button on this one, guys. Subscribe if you're not subscribed already, and this is the last video going into 2015. So, I really hope you've enjoyed it. Smash the like button, subscribe if you're not subscribed. Check out Gamer Saloon, if you do want to partake in any of the wager matches, and we'll be back another day with another episode of the Road to Glory Wager Showdowns Bundesliga.